I wouldn't do much differently. It is true that after the end of the war and so on, there was a lot of talk about why didn't you finish the job, and that continued until the second Gulf War. But we don't hear it anymore. And I think one of the things it's important to remember is we were trying to put this in the context of a world emerging from the Cold War. And one of the things we wanted to do was establish a sort of framework for how this world ought to operate. And therefore, we saw ourselves not just as the United States flexing its muscles and dealing with a bad guy, but as a representative of the world community dealing with a case of unprovoked aggression, or naked aggression, I should say. And so a lot of what we did was with that in mind. Strategically, however, we were very much aware that U.S. policy, since the British essentially turned over security interests in the region to us, had been, since the fall of the Shah, to balance the two largest military forces, Iran and Iraq, off against each other. And so when the war ended and insurrection started, we were criticized for not doing enough. We did not want Iraq split into its constituent parts. And to go on to Baghdad, take down the regime and so on, would also have destroyed that balance. So I think, in the end, what I would say is that Saddam Hussein was still a nasty guy, hadn't changed his goals. He was quite contained, in my mind. His military, as demonstrated in the second Gulf War, was very weak. He didn't have income enough to do his depredations in the region that way. And he was not a menace to the region or to the world community at large. So I'm quite content with how we stopped, when we stopped.